J Paul. J Sweet.
Let's go.
So again, what we did is that we took over 150 Nigerians. Even not Nigerians and not Nigerians. Okay, my own mistake is that many people in the UK for the first time, the chapter that we 2005. She was only 11 men when she came to us. So she was a bachelor, so she was 11 and yeah, so things like that, a lot of people don't know because we spend our money there to showcase Lagos. Wow. So when we film all this footage, we'll be taking it back to Europe, to London, to showcase on Ben TV. People now see, because they see that we're driving on top of language at 12:00 AM in the morning, even though my dad would go mad on the phone, like, I don't know about. And we look at it like, you know, it's nothing to us because we're used to that kind of lifestyle.
Yeah.
So this way the kind of things we're packaging, filming, and taking back to see over there. So we're going to different clubs, events, and stuff like that. I remember people were seeing all these fantastic events, big event with top
acts. I'm wondering that.
This is the country that people are saying that. So we were showcasing that with our own, with our own money, the government, nobody was helping us, we paid for our flight.
We're just living for the passion.
For the passion of the country, yeah. And then obviously, I'll give it up to Ben TV, the CEO, which is the first ethnic minority TV station in the whole of Europe, the first black TV station, you know, created 2002. You know, and that's what's the platform, you know, for all this African Nigerian music, for those in the diaspora to see what's happening. Because if not for that, we wouldn't be where we are today. I would confidently say that, you know. So we've helped to push the likes like Two Face, The Badge, Ikechukwu, Need to See, LD, Sacha, Tony Tetula, Idris Abdulkarim, Shino Peters, you know, we worked with the likes of all the A-list artists back in the UK. We've done shows, Downfall Drivers, Conga, you know, I can't get all the names.
So many to count.
Too many to count. So now when I come back, I see these hundred thousands of artists.
Yes, that's the new breed.
The new breed. You know, before I was able to get my fingers on
the candle.
Okay, this is. But now it's uncountable.
You see, the thing is, Nigerian artists are springing up every day.
Yes.
And we're bringing in new talents on a daily basis right now in Nigeria.
Yeah.
And anyway, to make it quick, for the sake of your fans who don't really know you as much as we do, I would like you to tell us much about Femi.
My name is Femi, I'm not sure. Everyone, they call me Femi Ben TV, which I'm used to, you know. And the reason that come about, Femi Ben TV, my name is Femi Amusho.
Okay.
When I used to come back, the first time I came back to Lagos was 2004, after 15 years abroad, you know, so it was a long time. And I came onto the platform of Ben TV then, and you wouldn't imagine, the first artist I met was Robin Manny. You know, and Rugged Man was living in Akoka then, you know.
Okay.
He was introduced by a friend in London. So meet this guy, he's an up and coming rapper. So Rugged Man kind of produced my first TV program.
Okay.
Yeah, in the UK.
Oh.
And Barry, this was 2004.
Oh,
you know, so and when I come, so every time I come and go, because people know that I take a lot, they give me musical videos
to showcase.
It's like, oh yeah, there's a guy in Ben TV called Femi. So when people now, when I come now, it's, oh yeah, it's Femi Ben TV.
That's
how so everyone just call me Femi Ben TV. So that was going year in year.
Okay.
So that name came about, Femi Ben TV, you know. So yeah, that's how that came about.
Wow, for the sake of people who are wondering how do you come about the name Femi Ben TV?
Yes.
I think that one has sorted right now. Yeah, quickly, let me ask about, if you look at it, though you've said a little bit about it now, but in the last four to five years ago, how can you assess the industry, what it used to be and what it is now, with the you know, the influence of people like the band, the wonderful, and the new pack that we have right here. What can you say?
I mean, what I'll say is I'm really happy to see what's happening, because back in the days, people used to criticize it. Nigerian music,
yeah.
The videos, okay. They were so, the production was so poor, the music wasn't dancing in the club, okay. You know, there was so much that people wasn't appreciating about Nigerian African music, and I see that the Nigerian African artists have sat down and feel like, you know what, we need to take this to another level, we need to show people that we've got the talent, you know, and you know, starting off by the likes of Two Face, Pink Square, my very good friend. You know, I can never miss out Peace Square. Peace Square, the people that kind of open the door, you know, for these young ones nowadays, you know. So I would say within the last 4 years, I've been so impressed, and, you know, like, wow, you know. So there's so much talent in this country.
Yeah.
So what's been happening, you know? So I've been so impressed to see all these talents coming out and showcasing what they're very, very good.
This is something I want to ask again. Being a known face, people know you everywhere, maybe at the airport, everywhere you go to. I mean, being a media person, how have you been handling your thing?
Oh, right now, I just give thanks to God. Okay. You know, I've always loved this media. I've always had passion for media since I was young. I remember my parents used to mock me back in the days, you know, obviously they wanted to study in it. Uni.
Okay.
I know my dad wanted me to be an accountant, if
okay.
I remember. So if they say, you know, when they say the black sheep of the family, so I'll put my hands up, you know what I'm saying? You know, to say I was that, because out of the whole family, I was the most stubborn ones that I rather do what I want to do, you know. So they used to make fun of me. Yeah, I always loved media. So when I was growing up, I wanted to be like the
sheep. Okay.
You know, the kind of girl and stuff like that. From there now, when I travel abroad, it was a different scenario, because that's why I knew there was racism, there's a lot to go through being in Nigeria and abroad, so I have to deal with those obstacles, you know. And obviously I studied media, I did my HND in media studies at Middlesex Uni, you know, and that was assisted, and when I finished that, I just came straight into television as a camera.
Wow.
You know, so I was doing a camera work and also did your editing there, you know, until I found myself that I started doing events, you know, producing programs, you know, and then I'm doing my own shows.
The fame suddenly came.
Yeah, it just came, you know, and I've worked with so many likes of producers, artists, you know, so many that can't even. You know, I want to give up to Kenny's music, to my role model. You know, I look up to them. D1 and Mr. KK himself, you know, ID, the Prof, you know, and then the Primetime Africa those days.
Yeah.
You know, yes, those are the people that I kind of look up to.
Yeah, thank you. Also, let me just check this. I know you've won BAFTA Award
a couple
of times.
Yes.
Congrats on that. Anyway,
thank you very much.
I would like you to tell us about the experience. What the joy, you know? Because to win such a prestigious award is not the job.
No, it's not. BAFTA Award is one of the biggest black entertainment, fashion,